peg is certainly one of the most powerful tools used for the purpose of media encoding. And yet, it is very simple, and easy to use. In this video, you'll learn one of the most basic usages of FFmpeg, that is, converting media files from one format to the other. The basic syntax of FFmpeg is quite simple. FFmpeg, -i, input file name dot input file extension, space, output file name dot output file extension. That's it. Here -i stands for input. Remember, the output file extension also determines the output file format. As an example, let's convert this MP4 file to MKV format. First, let's copy the directory, and then head to that directory in Termux, using the cd command. You can use the ls command to view the files in the directory. If you haven't installed FFmpeg yet, you'll find that video in the info card, and in the description. Now, let's execute the command, as FFmpeg, -i, input.mp4, space, output.mkv. The time taken for the process is dependent on the file size. Here there is a cool little trick to increase the speed of this process exponentially, which you'll learn later in the video. Once the process is finished, you'll find the converted output.mkv file in the specific directory. Similarly, you can use this method to convert other media files, like images. Audio files. And subtitles files as well. Now, there are tons of additional options you can add to the process. Here are a few of the most useful ones. The codec option can be used to specify the codec for the tracks in the output file. Here's how we can use this option, for specifying the audio and video codec. You'll find that the output file will have the same audio and video codec as specified. Even if you don't want to change the codec of the file, it's recommended that you use -c, copy, to copy the codec and prevent re-encoding, which would exponentially increase the speed of the process as mentioned earlier. Similarly, the bitrate option is used to specify the bitrate of the audio and video tracks. Its usage is similar to that of the codec option. And of course, the output file tracks will have the same bitrate as specified. The last option to talk about, is mapping. You can use it by adding -map0 to your command. This option is used to retain the additional audio tracks, and the subtitle tracks. Which means, if you don't use this option, FFmpeg will only retain the video, and the first audio track. Yes, you can use all these options in one command. But make sure you stay within the rules, and don't do anything silly, like using a codec that disagrees with the file format. If you learned something new in this video, then please give it a like, fill out the comments section with your queries, and subscribe to the channel for more videos on FFmpeg.